On June 6, 2021, I was one of the first commentators to make a highly popular video about creepshow art after her lolcow allegations initially came out. From there, what I first thought was a case of two-facedness and hypocrisy quickly morphed into something much more sinister. It was one thing to be transphobic and shit-talk your friends on a gossip forum anonymously, and it was another to be accused of stalking, harassing, and attempting to utterly ruin your husband's ex-girlfriend's life. Today, I wanted to make a quick reflection about creepshow art 1 year later, the impact this situation had on the art community, and how arguably one of the largest art commentators on YouTube suffered the largest sub-loss percentage in YouTube history. Hi guys, gals, gays, and envies, it's Omnia, and I haven't made a video in 6 months! I say this because I really need y'all to bear with me. I've quite literally forgot how to make videos and I am sputtering along like an old rusty bot incapable of performing its basic job. But don't worry though, I can guarantee you I will slowly get the hang of it the more I get into my element. So let's just jump into this. Before my channel got absolutely thrown into the shitter, I made a highly popular string of videos covering the creepshow art situation. I uploaded my first video on June 6, 2021, my second on June 10th, the third on June 15th, and the fourth and final one on June 26th. This series, so to speak, was probably one of the most popular string of videos I ever made in my YouTube career, and I even managed to hit 1 million views for the first time on my first video of the series. Again, before my channel got minced up like ground beef and left to rot and die. But that's neither here nor there. Since my last video on the situation, creepshow art returned on New Year's Eve to drop what can only be described as a bombshell of a video. Oh my god, it's 2 hours and 30 minutes long, what the fuck? And I was very much not equipped at the time to cover that, despite many people insisting I do. Inevitably, I just couldn't cover it because of circumstances surrounding my own situation and mental stability at the time, and while I know many people were looking forward to a video like that from me, circumstances just could not permit. I would apologize about it, but I'm not really sorry. Some things are just out of my control. But now that much time has passed, and I am much more okay, and I am much more equipped to handle such things, I think it's safe to say I am willing to look back on this situation and reflect, much like I do with many other dramas, and think about what has changed about my opinions, feelings, and thoughts. I have a lot of things I want to discuss, so let's hop into it. First thing, I want to make a really quick disclaimer that this video is very much predicated on the idea that you're already familiar with the creepshow art situation and understand the sequence of events fairly easily. If you don't know what happened with Shannon, the lolcow posts, Emily Artful, or any of the other important details, I suggest you start by watching the videos I've already made on the situation to get yourself familiarized before watching this one. Otherwise, let's get into how my opinions have changed about some things. The first thing that I want to mention was something I said at the start of my first video on creepshow art. Here's what I said. I have spoken to creepshow art or Shannon on multiple occasions, both in private and public settings. She has supported me multiple times on her own channel, even shouting me out at times and commenting on my videos in support of my content. One huge example of this was on her video titled The Worst Mommy Vlogger Ever, where she spent like 2 whole minutes just ranting and raving about my channel and how much she enjoys it, which I honestly really appreciated.
Before I jump into this situation and go over all the ins and outs, I want to do something that's really cruel and hurtful and mean, and I want to prank a channel of someone who I personally adore and think you guys will appreciate as well, that being Omnia here on YouTube. Like this girl, her mind, chef kiss, it's beautiful. And I think it would be really like cruel and underhanded and sneaky of all of us if we all went to her channel and like subscribed or something, like in a mean prank way, and like also if we went to comment on some of her videos letting her know like really nice things about herself, like a bully would. Let's like online bully right now. I think it'd be an awesome cruel prank. For those of you who aren't as cool as I am and aren't already standing this beautiful brilliant person, Omnia is a brilliant artist who runs an art commentary channel, and the first time I ever watched any of her videos was when she actually made one on me titled Creepshow Art Missed the Mark with her apology video, which obviously is a critical video of myself. I watched that video, I think the day it was made, and straight up, I left it thinking, holy shit, this girl's amazing. Like, she was criticizing me and holding me accountable things, and usually that's like less than comfy, but I left the video in a new state of mind and immediately subscribed to her because I saw her as someone whose opinion I respected and wanted to hear more from. I hate to be one of those people and do like the whole I was subbed when she had this many subscribers things, but legitimately I was I stan. I like subscribed immediately. I stan so hard. From that time onwards, I have watched her continue to grow and continue to thrive. She has made countless videos on various hard to touch on topics online, and she handles them with such care and poise. It's amazing. There have even been times when I am about to make a video on a certain subject matter and talk about something, and I will have seen she already talked about it at length, and I opt not to because she already stated everything better in a clever way and did a better job than I could ever hope to. Frankly, I think you guys should all go and subscribe to her because her work honestly speaks for itself. Her art is good, her commentary is spot on, and as someone who's been critiqued by her in the past, I can honestly state I believe she's coming from like the best place. She just wants to see people do better, and at the end of the day, that's all that matters. So go subscribe to her and like be like so mean and like comment something positive about her on her latest video. I think if we all like went over there and was just like really nice to her, that it would show her, you know, it would be like, haha, take that.
As you can probably tell, when I first included that clip, I was under the pretense that her shouting me out and commenting positively on my videos was a sign of care, mutual respect, and genuine support. However, after the entire series and recognizing her other behaviors with creators similar to me, I've since started to second guess that belief. I've had some people comment on the fact that they personally believe that her shouting me out on her videos was a sign of love bombing. For example, the Soft Mink Studio said, "Just want to say, Shannon's shout-out was not a shout-out. It was love-bombing. She was only complimenting you so that she could get you on her side and then use you. As much as hearing this may hurt, it is unfortunately true." Or Nighty Nightshade stating, "That quote-unquote shout-out was fake as hell in my opinion." Personally, and to be fair, I can't speak on Shannon's behalf and say whether or not she had ulterior motives when shouting me out that one time. What I can say, however, is that based on her own behavior that I've observed in relation to other creators like D'Angelo Wallace, Ready to Glare, Thuman, and many, many others, is that she's done similar things to them only for her to later shit-talk them on lolcow or use their darker moments to bolster herself up. For example, when it came to the race harassment Thuman was facing last year, Creepshow created two videos under what seemed like the intention to help Thuman out, but could also be read as love bombing, or using her situation to her own advantage to situate herself as a white ally for black artists. Like I said, it feels kinda slimy to assume what her intentions were. That's not to say that I don't think it's a possibility that she had ulterior motives. At least from what I've seen, she follows a very predictable pattern in which she follows to befriend other creators. And from what we've seen on her lolcow posts, it's rarely, if ever, authentic. If you're asking for my own personal conspiracy theory, and you can disagree if you wish, but I personally think that Shannon only befriended me because I was causing a lot of chaos in the art commentary community when I first started my channel. As you may know, I've gotten into my fair share of kerfuffles with people, and Shannon might have found that to be a valuable characteristic because she had a lot of skeletons in her own closet with people from the community. Therefore, she attempted to get on my good graces at the height of this dramatic era so that I could help criticize whoever she personally didn't like. I don't know, of course, but I think it would make sense. Hell, I never mentioned this in any of my previous videos, but I was mentioned in the lolcow post history too. It was never anything shitty or bad. If anything, it was defenses of me, but that only further strengthens my hypothesis that she wanted me to be well-liked on this gossip forum so that my critiques of her supposed adversaries would gain traction and my critiques of her would be decreased or thrown to the wayside completely. Let me know what you guys think, since I am kind of intrigued about how you interpret her attempts at a friendship or cordial relationship with me. Do you think she had ulterior motives, or was she being authentic? Let me know in the comments. The second thing I wanted to reflect on, now that it's been a year since the entire situation, is the ways in which I personally think some commentators and audience members alike mishandled what was probably the most sensitive part of this situation, and that was Emily Artful's recounting of her experiences with Anthony and Shannon. I think this was probably one of the few things I've had lingering thoughts about since the whole thing ended 1 year ago, and it's mainly because I have a lot of internal conflict about it. The main thing that kind of troubled me since the whole thing ended was was how some people discuss the events that Emily detailed with absolutely no tact whatsoever, instead viewing her trauma and what was objectively one of the worst periods of her life as quote-unquote entertainment. It's troubled me a lot because, as a creator myself, I don't think it's uncharacteristic of commentators to cover other people and the very unsavory things they've done or have been accused of doing. It's kind of what news and commentary and drama is all predicated upon, talking about people and the controversial and harrowing things they've done. But it also makes me a bit sick to my stomach to think of how genuinely horrible the things Shannon has allegedly done and how little care was put into that within certain subsects of the commentary community. I've had to tussle with this in my mind for a while now, but I've kind of been wondering, where do we draw the line when it comes to drama and trauma, or tea and abuse? And this could be an entire video in and of itself, honestly, but I know creators who cover very, very serious allegations in the same breath as accusing someone of tracing or being cringe. This blurring of the line between, okay, this is illegal and serious and needs to be treated as such, and I have nothing else to talk about, so let me discuss about how this person is a piece of shit, all rolled into one, causes a lot of cognitive dissonance for me, and I honestly think it should for you too. I don't think we're meant to consistently look at genuinely disgusting and deplorable actions as something that can be discussed in the same vein as disagreements between ex-friends or subtweets. It's just very concerning how watered down these allegations become when you pair it with the lolcow posts and where the situation first originated from. Initially, I could argue that it was drama. Creepshow was two-faced, a liar, a backstabber, talked shit about people, lost a lot of people's trust, and then it quickly turned from something petty to something really fucked up and illegal, to the point where Emily's well-being and safety was being called into question. And I feel like some people didn't recognize that shift and continued talking about the situation like it was some petty drama when it very clearly turned into something much, much more dangerous than that. It's a consistent problem I see in the commentary community, and I'm hoping that both creators and viewers can start to recognize that these situations need to be handled more carefully, because there's a large potential of harm to be created if these situations aren't handled with the care and tact needed to thoughtfully and sensitively talk about them. The third and final opinion of mine that has changed that I wish to reflect on is how the art community, the commentary community, and the art commentary community all fundamentally changed as a result of creepshow art being exposed. There's a lot, I think, that has changed about how viewers judge creators, how creators judge each other, how we view our platforms and mutuals, and just generally a lack of trust in one another altogether. I think the community has become a lot more cynical, and rightfully so. For someone who had 500,000 subscribers at her peak, I don't think we can deny that creepshow art was fairly well liked. Sure, she was rough around the edges, she had some less than savory takes every once in a while, acted like she knew more about racism than black artists did, and tried to align herself with those who have strong moral values. A nice creator who always uplifted other small creators from all across YouTube, featured her fans' speed paints in her videos so they could feel seen and included in her content, and always telling people they're amazing, how their content inspires her, and all the sweet, kind, and uplifting things she would say to her mutuals led a lot of people to go so far as to describe her as their art mom, or someone who consistently had good takes on things. She always made her allyship be known, whether it was for trans folks or other members of the LGBTQ community, people of color and black artists, body diverse people, sex workers, or any other traditionally marginalized group of people. And to take someone who seemed so nuanced and holistic, kind and considerate, who only wanted the best for people and made it a goal to defend the underdog when it came to racism or homophobia, all be ripped out from under everyone in an instant was very, very shocking to say the least. And that's I think what fundamentally changed the ways in which the art community and commentary community and any other subsect of those communities interacted with one another. You might think it's a little overdramatic to credit creepshow art as the main and sole reason the art and commentary communities ultimately disintegrated and broke down, but there's a method to my madness. For one, and I think this is the most obvious one, creepshow art has set the current world record for the highest percentage of one subscriber count loss to an online drama, which is a pretty shitty world record to set. I think if I were to set a world record, I want it to be like eating 13 pounds of Chips Ahoy in 5 minutes or something. I'll never be Matt Stoney. Not only did Creepshow lose over 200,000 subscribers since last year, her anonymous persona and her online persona was so far removed from one another that it quite literally gave everyone whiplash. Some of her closest friends didn't even think it could have been her writing those things on lolcow. The audience members who were dedicated viewers of her content refused to believe she could say such transphobic and homophobic things. For a while, a good majority of people genuinely believed her, until the story started to sound a little too convenient and everything fell apart. I also think that that slow disintegration of her story led a lot of people to feel very unsure and untrustworthy of one another. How do we know a creator is authentic? When the lies are so commonplace, how do I know I'm supporting a good creator? The problem is, you just can't. And I think that's what the creepshow art situation taught me. A lot of people act extremely differently in person as they do online. And while I don't think online personas are necessarily bad, it's definitely an issue when your fundamental morals online and offline don't align. And that's really scary. Looking back on all this now, I think it's fair to say that the trust issues that I've seen in myself, my creator friends, mutuals, and even viewers are at an all-time high. And I understand why. I don't know if eventually people will forget the lessons learned about Creepshow Art's downfall, but she certainly set a very different precedent about how creators interact with their mutuals and how viewers interact with creators. That's all from me. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comment section down below. What are some of the opinions about the Creepshow art situation that have changed for you? Any unpopular opinions or hot takes? Let me know. Also, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm gunning to hit 20,000 subscribers by the end of this month, so do me a huge favor and click that big red subscribe button down below and turn the bell notification on to all notifications so you never miss an upload. Lastly, a huge, ginormous, colossal, astronomical thanks goes out to 14 of my current Patreons: Glitchy Garbage, Rare T, Verlangen Lote Comics, Flavio Lee, Ash, Sarah, Maisie K, Chuli, Galaxy Brain, Maka Baka Cosplay, Campaign 2002, The Biophone, Rachel Krengel, and Noah Smashy Smash. I genuinely couldn't do this without you guys. If you're interested in supporting my content and future uploads, consider becoming my patron. The link is in my description below. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, I'll catch y'all next time. Bye!